Hello. Very good evening to you all. My name is Malati Raghunath. It's my pleasure to introduce our speaker, Dr. Chithra Madhavan. This is going to be a small talk followed by an interactive session. I'd like to first introduce Dr. Madhavan to you all. And from the looks of it, she's already known to many of you. So, very brief introduction about her. Dr. Martin holds an MA in Eastern Indian history and PhD in ancient history and archaeology. She is a recipient of two postdoctoral fellowships, and she has written on all types of topics related to temples of South India. She has published 9 books, and the latest one that is bilingual in both Tamil and English has been very extremely useful. Welcome, Dr. Chithra Madhavan. The stage is yours.
Worship, even when the structure is not 100% complete. So that
wanting to complete the session today, many times the temple has been very badly destroyed by the invasion that happened in the 14th century from the north of India. So this part is where the damage has mostly happened. Okay? And this little semicircle that you see here wasn't there originally. It's supposed to be my mom's side. You have given a part of the right there in the center. This was added sometime in the 16th or 17th century by another Indian king, another dynasty called the priest who ruled over here. So, very experienced before we get on to other things, there were such a few well known facts. They're not facts at all. This, right on top, is not one piece of stone. This is supposed to weigh some 80 tons and was rolled out of the land from 35 kilometers away from the airport, it's not one piece of stone, so it was not rolled up. And since it was not rolled up, there wasn't a map explaining the reflection of this or that is not. Many pieces of stone put together, and one piece of stone is covered with stucco, and lobster, which we call the bed in soil. The second thing that history books unfortunately tell us is that the shadow of the temple doesn't fall, and we unfortunately won't find the effect that, and when we are standing in the temple in the shadow of it, or the sun and someone tells us the shadow doesn't fall, we are okay with it. But then the sun does rise and release and get into it. Long shadow. So, that's another thing. The third thing, and okay, they don't have a picture, is that on one side of this imago, this is the structure of the main sanctum, that is the face of the Yoruba. So, there are YouTube videos going around telling us that Madhavan knew that Yoruba movement to come to India, and therefore he put a place for European and his wife over there. No way. Again, that is not a granite structure. It's a stucco structure that has been to there maybe for 100 years ago. So most temples have overruns. So this is very much what we call a feature of the religious kind of temple, the Dravida kind of temple. This is architecture followed in Tamil Nadu. And in every other part of the topic here as well. So the entrance to Madhavan style entrance is to Gopuram. So Gopuram itself has had a definition of very, very ancient trees, and there are somewhere midway in Gopuram. There are those that are smaller, and there are those that are much, much bigger. But what is really interesting about the Thanjavur temple is that, generally when you go to the temple, you see each Gopuram with small flower, etc. They don't have names, mostly. But here they have names. So this is the outer Gopuram. And this is called Kerala Kattai Sri Bhaskar, as per the institution given here. Bhaskar, to all those who know from here, is excellent. Sri Bhaskar, sacred. What is this word Kerala Kattai? He who destroyed Kerala was one of the disciples of Bhaskar. So, proud of this title was he, because he was the first king to conquer Kerala. That imposed that name upon this program. In addition to this word imposed, here is the name to this program. So we enter through the Kerala perspective of it. Before we enter, we know we just go in there. We should look at all these stones. Each is one piece. And then, the Thanjavur has shown that's the name. So they've gone many kilometers to say, look for the perspective. There's an arm over there, this report of the stones of death, many kilometers, how we brought it, what kind of transport we had, it was not here. So we go through this program, come to the next one, smaller one. This is called the Raja Rajan Siddhavati. So Raja Rajan was another type of that we had. So this even made, he was born other than one. And Raja Rajan was a type that he was born after he came. So the enter of the Kerala Madhavan go into Kerala and the temple. And incidentally, both these programs are all generated in most temples that we go to in India, in South India. The base is granite. The top part is the sandstone. So here is the base. So that's okay. coming into the temple. Then you can step outside and go. This is a shop that shows you the Kerala temple departure, the Nagarajan departure, and the Granite Vimana, which is the tallest Vimana in the whole world, goes to a height of 6.96 meters. But before that, there is a structure. You may like it, you may not like it, but it's there. So this entrance, again, has come at a very, very long gate then, and the Maratha team moved over the structure. So the Maratha and Swiss. So it went into the temple first day. And this is a canvas of a book called the Great Temple In Thanjavur. I mean, Indian and Bhaktivan is from AJJ Chattery, Sri AJJ Chattery, and he has climbed up to the top. And you can see the palace and almost 20 feet high. And the main Bhaktivan is the whole photograph. This is how the surroundings of the Bhaktivan took no more interaction. And in 2020, there is a peak with 1,000 years. There was a grand celebration and promote the coins and first day tower and stamp the issue of honor. There was a grand, grand two in the temple. Now, this is the ground plan of the Petal temple. So, when we read books, when we read stories on history, mostly in Babylon, they tell you that they have a business there. This is the only sponsor of the building of this temple. And the architect was called Rajarajan Silvan Satcha. Satcha is someone today in carpenter. Those days, Satcha was also a property of the Silvan Satcha great power. Rajarajan Silvan Satcha, Rajaraja had given to his friends. Honor him, credited him, his own friend. So he was Rajarajan Silvan Satcha. Now, when we say the temple built in the name of Rajaraja Chola, the temple is right and the temple is not holy. Why is it not fully right? Because it is coming from the outer Gokulam, it is coming from the inner Gokulam. Both are at the time of Rajaraja Chola. So this is the Nandi Mandapam. It comes to Nandi Mandapam. This is not of Rajaraja. This is 6th century later. This is 9th century. This Mandapam is not Rajaraja. Ganapati Shrine, Marathati is much later. Karuna Deva Shrine, much, much later. Subramanya Shrine, 9th century is 17th century. This is Ayati Shrine. That is what Parvati is one of them, like India, Pandya being in 14th century. Pandya being in the Solar Nation, they were practicing the Solar Nation, they were in bouncing back in 12th century, the Solar Empire was extinguished. The Pandya is the last Solar King, they made some of the standards in the middle. We did all that. But still, the Sandhya was canceled. By another name, so there is sure they added a Parvati Sandhi phantom. Then the temple had a Parvati phantom. That was their possibility. That's why they explained later. This is from the time of Rajaraja. In fact, the volume of one that one point one day left there. And you went to say it's not Rajaraja. Others had wrong, but he added a box. Okay, so this is now where you find the wonderful inscription of the temple, of which approximately 50 belong to the Chola and later. So, most of the inscriptions, many of the inscriptions are here. So, right inside the way people are going is the way to the main temple. So, this wall and that wall, and on the other side, are where many of the inscriptions are here. This is the most important place in the sense because this is where Shivalinga is inside. So the outer wall of the Shivalinga, outer wall of the shrine mountain Shivalinga are very important. There you find Rajaraja Suresh's intent. This temple. And you know, one other person whose contributions were etched over there, next to Rajaraja. That was not his only son and Yuvraj Rajendra. It was not his wife, it was not his better And how we know that this is So all these are the images. Oh, and I have to come
little bit here, lower tabla. Notice his foot. Okay? So it's not very clear. I want you to notice this part. This is a snake. A snake is a mouth open. I don't know whether you're expecting the snake here. The mouth of the snake is the head. It's there. Maybe I should just be here. Can you see the snake is a mouth open and there's everything hanging out of the mouth? This is how it is. You know the size of an elephant. Then if the snake is going to be following the elephant, if the mouth of the snake is given, you can imagine how big the mouth is going to be. You can then imagine how big this foot is. In case. And if this foot is going to be that big, you can imagine how huge this one is. And this one arata has four hands, and this hand is what is called Vishwaya arata, astonishing. It's pointing to the Shiva, the Vishwa, he's the Lord of the world, he's so good. We have to understand what this is. Okay, so so here, right on top, there is just one arata, so many, one is Purana, one, but right on top, you have. Can see Shiva here with a bow and arrow. These many of this God called Chithra. So it's the almost look at. And Dr. Ramaswamy is a great actor in this unfortunately. He didn't agree that this was going to be Chithra, but many others do. So why are so many Chithra? Chithra comes to her that this Shiva destroys the world. So Raja Raja himself. And conquered the unconquerable Chetra, the unconquerable Pandya, and the unconquerable king of Simhara, that is Sri Lanka. So he maybe associated himself as Sukuramsaka, and that's why his consciousness for this particular day is zero. Maybe, maybe. But there are many Sukuramsaka up there. So many more players in Sukuramsaka, doing a different one, Durga and Vaishnava. In scriptures, and I told you more than 100 of them, mostly in the Tamil script, the Tamil language, almost all of them. Even if you know Tamil today, you will be hard to read this because the Tamil script is the word. So, look at the same thing in the Bodham and Yamda, Bodham and Yamda, and this is the Nandi Mandala. This is built in the 17th century, and the Nandi inside. The monolith. You know, one of the biggest monoliths of India, Nandi from India, and this was 19th century, 999. There are lots and lots. This is the original Nandi that was there in the time of Raja Raghunath. So maybe this is a Buddhist. So you think 2010 and it's not as safely as a Raja Nandi, but no. He's as cute because. You know, if I was going to see, I want to see Shiva there, and all of you are blocking behind you, or this, I do this, to see somebody who wants to see, that's what Nandi is doing. This is far more natural than the one that's there right now. Maybe he was having a piece of that is here, and the knight decided to move him aside, and he was a very big one where he is now on the ceiling of the Nandi. He could go there, turn into Nandi and Durga. You see, Maratha, Ira, and all this is there, any of them are perfect. Now, the outermost compound is a temple, it was constructed by Rajaraja's commander-in-chief, his army general, on Krishna and Rama. So, there are many additions about this. This is the sanctum of Sudramanya, which I showed you in the ground plan. The knife by architecture, but the untrained eye won't be able to see any difference between architecture of the structure and the main structure. Almost right in the same. So we have many structures over here on the wall of the Supermania, right? And this is the panorama. This is how the Abhishek is getting structure. This is how beautiful it is. It's very wonderful. And people who are trained to know how to distinguish this kind of architecture, they can use that Buddhism. This is a 9-period how different they are from the water paragraph that you saw the one where they're handed one. It's a different stone and they have a different polish. They're very extremely different. Very, very successful. So Ganesha Center, may have been a Ganesha Center earlier, but the one that you see here belongs to the Maratha building, this one. And this is the Maratha doorway. The Maratha painting also inside the temple. Many contributions to the Maratha painting. They're all there. So you have Chola painting, nice painting, Maratha painting. So this is the contribution. And somehow I realized it very much because it marks the view of your school. Now, the Egyptians get out there. Egyptians are really, really very big. It's something that in the time of Rajaraja, more than 60 metal images were donated to the temple. I'm using the word metal. These are the Ustama motifs, the professional images. Some of them were of copper, some were Kancharoga, combination of fine metal, some were pure gold, some were silver. All of it is enumerated, the height, the weight, everything. Among those or metal images that were donated to the temple, two were called Ardavana. They didn't use the word Nakaraja. Ardavana is the Lord of Dam. Two were Ardavana. One was donated by Rajaraja himself, the other one was by one of his kings. Now there is only one of those 60 odd images left. And this is the one. So how do we know whether this is the one given by Rajaraja or by his queen? One of his queen. How do we know that? Because the inscription that is there, one inscription is damaged. The other inscription is the one that gives you the highest donation. Every detail of this, and we come to the conclusion of the non-forming and come to the conclusion that this is the image donated by Rajaraja himself. And this was in active worship in that temple, still in active worship. So one thing you will see about this Nataraja, which is a little different from. Many other Nataraja is this, it's not his head, not straight. So he's something highly the artist has got this particular. Temple in the name of the Lord, we don't go very much, shorter by a door of the were listed 400 ladies who were attached to the temple. Today it's considered that thing, but the inscription mentions a very Tamil word, Kali Kendi. Kali in Tamil means temple. Kendi are ladies. The ladies who were attached to the temple, they were in dancers, they were in doing various other things. Two or three close to the temple were reserved for these ladies. 100 houses on each side of each street. Each of them 200, each of their names is given, and each temple can only give various houses being part for the state. So these dancers, these ladies working in the environment of various other temples in Tamil Nadu, by order of the transfer, they were brought to this around temple of the temple. So the name is given, then only the temple is given, only the state is given, and then they were brought here. The terms and conditions of their employment are given. So many musicians, so many dancers, so many people. Not even one lady dancer was brought from Sri Lanka. Not one. They came from all of the places, but not Sri Lanka. Why? I think. Because the home of the daughter of dance, and we didn't want to borrow one of these dancers for a long time. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Chithra. Such a delightful presentation. If history were taught like this while we were in school, many of us would have taken this as a subject, right? Unfortunate that we had such bad. That's all I can say. I'm going to sit down with Chithra. I'm going to have the honor of asking her the first three questions before I open up to the rest of you, who I'm sure will have much more in-depth questions to answer. Okay, so I'm going to ask you the first thing about the collection. This is the collection which, even in the first Mahal Library, as you know, even in the video that was shown, and this is about 6 months ago, I think, when I was there, and the video produced by the Archaeological Society, it talks about seeds of various plants that are stored in the collection. If there was a stage, how this seeds would be preserved, and rather than storing them in the fourth part of preserving on the cross. So, is that true? Yes, go ahead, three questions.
No, but you heard it sometimes you are talking. So.
Yes, I did, and I was quite mesmerized with it. You see the connection on top of the Vimana direct to the the collection on top of the Vimana and the Bhutra directly follow in that. And they are filled with grain. That much is there. So if it is there and it is stored, that they are then lighting it simply is the solid machine, right? So these earth circles. So as long as the collection is fixed, suppose lighting is there, it is completely charred in there. So then there is a question of, you know, in kind of drought taking in trees and planting the second level. So this is why they are on top of the Vimana. In this temple, the Vimana is much higher than the Gokuram. In many other temples, the Gokuram is the solid point. That's where the collection was placed. And inside it are lots of money of lots of grain, like we said, the earth, the electricity, and what is inside is char. So once you get here, we are supposed to find out what is called the Abhishekam. That's when everything is taken out of clean. The inside of it is completely clean. The outside is polished, gold plated, whatever. More grain, new grain is put. Okay. So part of it, some part of it is new, but it's not for the. Okay. So one more question is the connection between the three and what is the similarity between the late Mahasuram, Dharasuram, and what is similar? How did the kids deviate from their parents? Okay, so the center of the temple, So Rajendra, Rajaraja's son, decided to shift his capital to Kalyan.
we think of Bangalore. Wrong. We should be thinking of India to this sort of camp. Because that was for far longer than that is for this program. Almost 3 years. Far longer than that. So why it happened when there was Bangalore? We should think of Bangalore. And the Rajeshwara temple, which is mainly for the Jodishwara, which is also for the Jodishwara, is not exactly a carbon copy of the conservation. Very similar, but not 100% the same. First of all, the base is the same as the Pandavata, but the height is there. So there are some foolish people who tell you that he wanted to make something as big as the Pandavata temple as thought, but the Thanjavur temple site and saw actually. There is only some sort of that is another kind of beauty there. Plus, again, I'm quoting from the base of the Thanjavur very important there, and then it becomes we shouldn't really be comparing, but then we need to also. The sculptures, the stone sculptures that are there on walls, all the walls of the Indian temple are far superior to those on the walls of the temple. There is one particular idea for Chandesha Aluramurti. Shiva faces the Sarvati by his side, and he is planting a flower garland on the gate of his divinity and Desha. So look for the sublime look on the gate of the divinity. Lord is playing a flower garland on the very looking down in the city of Kataka. Shiva's face is full of compassion. Parvati is quite small in size and a little bit of background, but it really doesn't matter over there. If Shiva is more attention is on his divinity. Okay. I will open up the floor for questions from your audience.
Okay, so I have shown an arch entrance built by the Maharaj. Now, one thing I do not know, but the older entrance is up. Do not use this arch. Okay. When is arch beginning to appear in Indian architecture? And why is it that the older temples did not contain
this
arch?
This question has been asked many times. But we have to find out why it was because it was in a great architect. Right? And looking at the inside of the Thanjavur temple, he built something that was three or four walls around all the objects. It wasn't used, but we don't know why. Here, as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, it's Tamil Nadu.
Yes, sir.
The cordon method was used. Right. There's one more thing, and I don't have photographs to tell me what I'm saying. When you see the walls of the temple, two big stones being there, one on top of the other. You will also find that there is absolutely no binding material to make them. So the reason is that they were allowing the stones to move in case of the earthquake, ever so slightly, so that they will stay in place. Now that we want to transfer all our walls, when there is a red shift, you see cracks happen. That didn't happen in the stones did move ever so slightly, and that meant a certain safety. Also, if you find one stone there, you'll find that the next one is not put directly on top. Put a little between and it's a second you have noticed that. This is for balancing the weight. Not a problem for it.
Yeah. Yeah,
I thought there were the European citizens at the time of the other 2,000 years back. The Yavanas getting to the Greeks and the Romans. But there is a summer time, a summer day. We have answering in the example of the temple and the food structure is typically European and all that. So they may have been some foreigner there as trainer leaders in the time in Brazil as well. So we don't have record. They may have been there. But to point to this particular structure and say that Brazil is a four-storm and foreigner is not a continental period structure at all.
I also want to ask a silly question. I read in an article that the cumbersome on the top of the temple so heavy that it was moved into place by constructing a new climbing frame 7 kilometers long. So,
You see, this Vimana man both sides, you thought it had both sides. So, in case we thought,
and we should have
so you and I, I'm the chief architect, you're all my assistant. So, I removed this one block of stone from somewhere, many kilometers, and placed it here. So, I need to put another stone on top. So, all of you are going to let me and you're going to put another stone. Put this third stone up there. So, we are going to do that. And that's going to be, we're going to push, and we're going to get it up there. Now that seems to be the next one, the land has to become longer, land has to become higher. And then the medicine will be caught and it will take them to our house. So if you have to go on building a map in one direction, from the top case on the other side, so we're going to have to build four sides, so the land will have to be circular. You understand? Mandy or both sets. You have to keep building all those sets together. You can't just build one set. So why are we pointing to one particular village from the town, whatever, family, you know, right home, whatever. We are pointing to one village on our panel and think that's where the land came from. The land can't talk from what to what. The land just comes from all the town. It's a circuit of much thing that keeps going up and up and up. And all the stones have to be taken up that way. And even if they carry different form of pieces of stone, different categories are instead of one big piece and big piece of thing, even the different pieces have to go up their ramp. There's no other way that can do it. It's not just for one minute. The ramp came all around.
So, we're talking about today's inscriptions that are there in the temple. And the inscriptions of the temple in the answer that they did also the columns, which affix the names and the people that are asking what the study of the temple, what the exactly was about the individuals that are on the temple.
The names of some of the Lakumana's grand speakers are musicians are. But what type of dance in particular? That is not.
Or when it was performed?
When it was performed, no. But one thing we do know that in any temple, till very recently, very recently only, what is called the Shodesha Upasthana was like. Upasthana is in Hungary. Shodesha has a state. This is super deep, but like the land, everything you can speak down, music, recitation, data, and exercise. All these offerings are wrong. I think music and dance are very important, which is why you have to have dancers and musicians as employees of the temple, just like you have three. And there are just any temple has that, any temple has a system, but just to gather as a royal temple, he made 400 maybe. So you have no particular dance style or no particular ritual dance at all. That's not it.
I have two questions. One, I'm curious to know more about that fall scene, whether that is seen in other senses as well, or whether it's unique to the sense. The second question, I think it could be totally off the mark. This style of architecture or this Chithra temple impact the temples in Cambodia in any way in terms of the architecture and style?
So, to answer your first question, that all feeling was prepared at the very next day. It wasn't to arrive at the So it shouldn't be an interactive space. Because we know the open still TED talk is there, or that is, it's not there in other sectors, because you see, this kind of demand will hardly be there. You see, it is again in front of them. That's all. Most type of environments are very short structures, very small structures. Even if you go to your big sector like Paramount, you know, or Pulumalai, or Pihachi, so the main sanctions are very small, and the height of the environment is not very high. No question of all failing anyway. This happens in this sense and happens at a very late. Now, to come to this connection between the Cholas and Cambodia, the Cholas didn't conquer Cambodia. Rajendra Cholas, one of the proper faith inscriptions in Rajendra Cholas says, the king of Cambodia, Cambodia, sent a golden chariot to him and his wife. I think that man was shivering in his boots because Rajendra Dami had already gone to Indonesia. Cambodia is not too far away. So he needed to bring his wife. The donor didn't point to a digital connect Cambodia. The kind of architecture that you see in Cambodia is not entirely Chola. The people down there are not wearing it for this, but it's not true. It is probably an amalgam of many different types of architecture. If you ask me, for example, the temple of Orissa of Mom, they really do. I'm not saying that the entire thing is the Kalinga type of architecture, no, but it is an amalgam. What is very similar in most of the temples of Cambodia are the inscriptions that are in Sanskrit. They are the same inscriptions for Grantha, which is found only in Cambodia. The Grantha script was used in Tamil Nadu from the time of the Salomon Empire. So inside some. And that you see in Cambodia. Also, you see a sculpture of you all know there are 63 great Shaivite saints for the Nayanar. Three of them were ladies. One of them was an extraordinary devotee Shivanaya. And her sculpture is in Cambodia. So they were very clearly a Tamil connection. But that sculpture of Kayakanamaya is three Chola. So the Chola connection wouldn't be there for sure. Most would break their engineer. And I cannot say that the temple is architecture and there is totally from the Tamil
dynasty. Thank you for all your but I just want to be clear to you. One of the world mentioned by the whole book on Mudia. How much of it is true that they are this model broken? They talk about this ramp and that. What is the truth?
Okay, I haven't read it there, but I know that it has a lot of facts in it. We must understand that these are works of historical fiction. Even Calcifonian films are works of historical fiction. So there are some elements that we must be told. The land was there. I'm saying you cannot build, these are all the Thanjavur temple. You can't build even a small temple without the land. You have to push the stones up. You can't physically lift the stone. You need a land. All I'm saying is to say that the land came only from a village called Sarapayam is wrong. And think that only this big, big boulder, which is not just one boulder, it was rolled up that one grand stone. There was a snoring ramp, there was a ramp. It was a circular ramp on all sides, from all sides, not just from not the one incline from one side. That's what it is. The ramp was there. And it was an elevated number. The water, okay, at the large, it's not from the time of Narayana. More came about at a much later time and for purposes of defense. they want to get back to the more again at a much, much way of eating. But there's one thing I didn't mention, that it's not totally connected to the temple, but connected to Radha Radha.
They don't have any experience. does any inscription mention why letters left undecorated?
The first Mandapa in the commentary is not a Jura Mandapa. It's a 9-page Mandapa. Incidentally, many pillars in the script are inscribed. Jura pillars have inscriptions. And as long as this is technical, that is in the media.